Hey, really, it's okay, Gwen. I can do all those invoices later.
Trucker, why don't I make out the checks and then you can just sign them? Trucker? It is June 1st, you know. Hey.
I know. Yeah, Trisha used to help me do payroll every month. We used to get pizza and just turn up the music.
Trucker, I know. I know. I think of her every day, too.
I'm dreading Christmas.
You know, it's her birthday that comes first.
I know, and then Valentine's Day and all the other firsts without her.
I know.
I know you do. Listen, I know how hard this is for you, too. I'm sorry.
I actually, picked up the telephone to call her the other day.
I'm just gonna have to learn to take care of all this stuff alone.
You will. Just give yourself time. Ah, well, well. Buck Houston's payroll sheet.
Yeah.
Trucker, do we know anything more about this guy?
I don't know. You were the one who was living with him.
Well, yes, until he moved in here with you.
What, didn't it work out?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know if it ever got started. That guy is sure full of surprises.
Yeah, he's just so strange. He sold his precious bike to the first guy who came along. The guy walked in and said, here's $5,000, and he said, it's a deal. Thing was worth at least $7,000. Very strange.
Do you think he's leaving Corinth?
I don't know. Do you want some more coffee?
I'm going.
Please.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Buck Houston, what is your story?
Why don't you ask him?
It's time I do something a little bit more than ask him.
$5,000 cash, Tess. Pack and call a cab. This will help get you going someplace far away.
If I was leaving, which I'm not.
You managed to avoid seeing Curtis at Trucker's the other day.
I didn't avoid anything. Curtis was in one room and I was in another.
You didn't go out of your way to reintroduce yourself either. But then I don't guess Curtis Alden will ever forget you. Not that he doesn't have enough problems of his own these days.
Yes. I'd know that fragrance anywhere. Forever yours, right?
Glenn, to talk to you. Hannah's scholarship is under review.
It is. Well, at least she came forward and admitted that she falsely accused Jeremy. That should be a big point in her favor.
But will it be enough to keep her in school?
I'll see that it is.
Can you do that?
Curtis Alden will be played by Michael Lord.
We said we'd meet at PJ's for breakfast. I was waiting for you.
I know. Hannah might lose her scholarship. I came to Clay for help.
You should have asked me.
Actually, Curtis, I'd been involved in this from the beginning. Matter of fact, it was my fault that the whole thing got blown out of proportion.
Not to mention looking for any excuse to win points with Dinah Lee.
Curtis, Dinah Lee came to me.
I did. Well, your father's on the board of directors at AU.
And I probably can get influence, though.
Since you have so much to discuss, maybe we should cancel our meeting.
No, no. Dinah Lee and I, we can discuss this later, right?
We have plans later.
We do.
You can call me if you have anything to say to Dinah Lee.
Curtis, I am just trying to help.
To help? I know all about your help,
Art, Dad. Stop it. Why does everything between the three of us always have to be such a battle? Look, I am sorry that I came. I'll work this out on my own.
If you could work it out yourself, you wouldn't have come to see me in the first place, Dinah Lee.
Can you really help her sister?
I think I can.
Well, then what are we fighting about? Give it your best shot.
I will. Well, I'm glad that's settled. Isn't there another little piece of unfinished business between us, Curtis?
I'm gonna go.
No, stick around. This won't take long.
So you've thought about my proposition?
Mm-hmm.
And?
I've decided to accept your offer and run AE with you and Mom.
Curtis, are you sure about this?
I have never been more sure of anything in my life. Or more ready for a challenge.
Curtis isn't going away.
You think I am?
I was hoping the cash would give you a push in the right direction. Why don't you just do us all a favor and take off?
Us? Tell me, who are you protecting here, Curtis or your brother?
You leave Trucker out of this.
If you have a problem with the company, why don't you leave?
I live here.
And I work here. So why don't we just put our heads together and try to find a way to deal with Curtis?
There is no more we, Tess. I covered you once. Once is all you're going to get.
What is this? I haven't done anything wrong.
Not yet.
What difference does it make to you where I am?
You think it won't make a difference to Curtis?
Curtis can't do anything to me.
He can do anything he likes. He's got everything to lose, and yet he's got nothing to lose.
Let me tell you something, Buck. I will survive, just like you. And for now, surviving means staying in Corinth with Trucker and his son. And if you have a problem with that, that's too bad. I'm not afraid of you. And I'm not afraid of Curtis.
What are you afraid of, tough guy? Huh? What keeps you awake at night? I remember a time when you weren't so fearless.
Yeah.
I remember you scared. Real scared.
No, I employ the man. Yeah, his name is Buck Houston. Look, all I need is the record number that corresponds to his birth certificate from your I-9 form. Well, of course I had it at one time. It was lost. It was lost in an office fire, okay? Look, how can I tell... What hospital? How can I tell you which hospital he was born in? Fine. Thank you, never mind. I will get the information I need elsewhere. Wretched woman.
Sure, if you asked him, Buck would tell you everything you needed to know.
Trucker, God, you startled me.
Well, I'm sorry, I just... Why are you acting like a CIA investigator?
I just, I don't know. I don't want to upset Buck with a whole bunch of personal questions. You know how strange he can be.
Well, you'd understand. I mean... Son of my... You two were close, weren't you?
Were we? Look, I thought we were, okay? And I thought he felt it, too, but now I don't know. Buck is so guarded, who knows?
I thought women liked the silent type.
Well, he's not the silent type. He's the secretive type. I mean, he just blows into this town. He never says anything about his life, anything about his family. It's almost as if there's not a soul in the world who cares anything about him.
Right. Besides you.
Is someone looking for the guy, you know? Does he have a family? Does he have a girlfriend? Does he have children?
Maybe the police are looking for him for some horrific crime.
Well, why don't you ask him?
I've tried, Trucker. I've thrown a bunch of hints, but he just grins that grin at me, which makes you want to slap it off his face or... You know, he is the most irresponsible man I think I have ever met in my life.
Well, he's great in the shop.
Oh, come on. He's completely unreliable.
He's never been late for work.
Oh, really? Well, that is an absolute miracle. The man owns a watch. One watch. And it's broken. What is so funny?
I just, nothing. I just never thought I'd see the day. You finally found a man you can't control and it is driving you crazy.
Oh, well, thank you very much, Dr. Freud. Don't you have to go to work now?
No, I'm the boss. I can go in whenever. I mean, just go for it. I mean, just jump in and face your feelings. You never know. It might be fun.
Welcome to AE, Curtis.
Thanks.
Oh, I am so proud of you. We are going to be a family again. In Tricia's honor, and for our own good, I'm going to do everything I can to make it all work. Now, why don't you two grab yourself some breakfast?
Curtis, go after him. Go after him and tell him you can't do this.
I can handle it.
What if you're wrong about that?
What if this is his way of making peace?
He's trying to destroy us, and you know it.
I know that nothing can come between us unless we let it. We're not about to do that, are we?
I wonder.
Besides, if you had the courage to face my father alone, certainly I could face him every day at work for a couple of hours.
Why should you have to? Curtis, this isn't about a job. This is about your family's control over you. They didn't even have to grab you. You just walked right in. And Clay will be around all the time. He'll be showing up at the house, making phone calls on business. This is wonderful. This is really
so great. What are you really afraid of? Me working with my father? Or you being unable to face him and all the memories?
Curtis, I have told you. Clay and I are history, and I feel nothing for him anymore.
Then we have nothing to worry about, right?
Mr. Justice, there is an urgent call for you.
Thank you. Hello?
Me, you alone?
No.
You better find some place where we can talk. We've got a problem.
I'll get right back to you. Donnelly, I completely forgot. I've got this meeting that I've got to be at.
With who?
Right, nobody you know. I'll see you later, huh?
Scared, very scared.
Did you get it? No, don't tell me. I'm never gonna get out of here.
How dare you remove your veil?
I never again believe a word you say.
Look, that's your problem. Leave it alone. You're already going to make matters worse for the lady.
That's embarrassing in front of my friends and family.
I didn't mean to.
You would stop behaving like a cheap American tramp.
Please stop it or hurry me. Go!
My wife, and you will marry me!
You are my wife. We'll obey. 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 Obey! Hey, Trekker! You home?
Birth certificate number PN233778.
Buck, hi. I didn't hear you come in. Trucker's out in the back.
Why don't you just ask me? What else you want to know, Gwen? You got my birth certificate? Military records? Last known address? How about shoe size or my favorite color?
Buck, look, come on. I was helping Trucker do his payroll, and I just got curious. That's all.
You're looking for answers in all the wrong places. The questions you want to ask have nothing to do with those documents.
Really?
Go ahead, fire away. Okay, how about Buck? Can you give me your word you'll never do me wrong? Look, Gwen, the answer's right here. What do you see?
Very blue eyes.
Look harder. It's not where you're from or where you're going. It's who you are. And what you're doing today that counts. This minute, this moment.
Buck, look, I'm sorry. I learned the hard way not to trust anything I can't see.
So do I.
Some of us protect ourselves a little better. Hey, I ran into that guy who bought the bike from me. He's very happy.
Well, he should be.
It's like the deal of the century. I mean, that bike was a classic, man. It's worth a lot more than you got for it.
Well, it's only money.
Well, $5,000's still a lot of money. You, must have needed it fast and for a good reason.
Surprised to see me, Tess?
Clay, don't do this.
Do what?
Punish your son for being who he is.
Punish him? Don Lee, I love him. I want him to be part of my life.
Why does that have to include running AE?
I don't know. He's going to have children eventually. I'm thinking of his future.
I'm his future. His children will be my children, Clay. Clay, don't try to read something into this that isn't there, okay?
I'm not.
You don't have to treat him like a 3-year-old.
You know, not 1 hour goes by that I don't think about you. It's the same for you, isn't it?
I think about how destructive you've become.
I don't believe you.
Believe this. I love Curtis. And you have to get used to that.
Can you get used to it?
Things are not going to change, Clay.
No, they're not. We're going to always have this feeling for each other, Diane Lee.
Every time we see each other, it's going to be there. And there isn't a thing that you or I can do about it.